Hello again, and welcome to Behind the Ballet. I'm Elizabeth Kaye, and in this talk, I'll be telling you about Crime and Punishment, a stunningly dramatic full-length ballet created for American Ballet Theater and our spectacular dancers. This new, utterly compelling work is receiving its world premiere in ABT's 2024 fall season. Crime and Punishment is a ballet rendering of the epic, ingenious psychological tale written in 1866 by Fyodor Dostoevsky. Clearly, it takes a daring and exceptional choreographer to bring a book of such depth and complexity to the ballet stage, and I can think of no choreographer better suited to do this than the remarkable Helen Pickett. Now, if I were to describe Pickett to you in a single word, the word I'd choose would be impassioned. Her passions embrace movement, music, words, books, and ideas, which is why she's already created more than 60 ballets that include riveting works based on Gustave Flaubert's classic tragedy, Madame Bovary, and on The Crucible, Arthur Miller's timeless drama. Pickett is a native of San Diego, California. As a young dancer, she joined Ballet Frankfurt, a company directed by the revered dance luminary William Forsythe. She performed with them from 1987 to 1998, appearing in 20 original productions. But Pickett's insatiable curiosity and energy eventually led her to also join and perform with the Worcester Group, an experimental theater company based in New York City. And for Pickett, this unique background in dance and theater endowed her with tools that allow her to create eloquent choreography that we in the audience absorb not only with our eyes, but with the entirety of our beings. Pickett sees the Crime and Punishment ballet as what she calls a study of a volatile and remarkably complicated human being who is wildly intelligent and vulnerable, yet incapable of love. The novel, she says, is, and I quote, a study of human nature that shows us that human beings are many different things, and we are all capable of all things, especially when pushed by the injustices of society. It is, she adds, a story of our era, or any era, which is why it stamps the test of time. Now, in approaching this ballet, Pickett worked closely with her wise and trusted creative partner, James Bonas, who trained as an actor and is now a multifaceted director who works in theater, opera, video design, and animation, and dance. In their continuing and successful collaboration, they are, as Pickett says, co-directors who work side by side in the rehearsal studio. Early on, after months of consideration, they made a significant alteration to Dostoevsky's story, in which the tormented protagonist, Raskolnikov, is a man. But because this is a story about what it means to be human, they made the radical and intriguing decision to have Raskolnikov portrayed in alternate performances by male and female dancers. Their point is that this is a story about humanity, not about gender. And this makes perfect sense because Raskolnikov has what are generally regarded as male and female energies and qualities that befit a generous, vulnerable soul who is also a brutal murderer. Raskolnikov is a brilliant student whose grinding poverty requires abandoning the education that means everything to him. Thus, Raskolnikov is a person in turmoil, a person who, to survive, must pawn the things that he holds most dear. When forced to pawn the watch that was a precious gift from his father, the pawnbroker coldly tosses coins at Raskolnikov, leaving Raskolnikov in a murderous rage. Raskolnikov wants to kill this pawnbroker, despite being fully aware that murder is regarded as an unforgivable crime. But why, Raskolnikov wonders, can men like Napoleon kill so many decent people and be deemed a hero, when it would be regarded as an unspeakable crime if Raskolnikov were to rid the world of one evil soul? And so, armed with this self-created rationalization, Raskolnikov kills the pawnbroker. In the melee that ensues, the pawnbroker's sister is also killed. Now you may ask, given these thoughts and the deadly deeds that spring from them, is Raskolnikov also evil? In fact, Raskolnikov is a paradox, an intriguing contradiction who is neither wholly bad nor good. Yes, Raskolnikov is a murderer, but one who is also capable of tremendous warmth and generosity and is a devoted family member and friend who will gladly give away his or her last coins to assist the stranger. The story is telescoped into two tumultuous weeks, which suits Helen Pickett's choreographic style perfectly. As she told me, I like a roller coaster. So after the murder, Raskolnikov expects to be caught, but isn't. Instead, he or she wanders the city while the canny, determined detective is closing in. Along the way, we meet other characters. Sonia, the shy, self-sacrificing young woman who prostitutes herself to support her family. Though at first she is fearful of the half-crazed Raskolnikov, Sonia is an angel figure whose ability to empathize and to love are endless. She is not repelled by Raskolnikov's crimes. Her focus is the saving of Raskolnikov's soul. Then there is Raskolnikov's friend and sister, moral and compassionate individuals whose romantic joining together seems not only right, but inevitable. For them, Pickett has created an enchanting love duet that reveals the emotions swelling in their hearts. They possess a quality Raskolnikov tragically lacks, the ability to love. Yet Raskolnikov is able to perceive the utter goodness that Sonia radiates, and they dance together in what Pickett describes as a pas de deux of care. In choreographing this or any ballet, Pickett views her work as collaborative. Rehearsing the dancers, she shows them what she wants, but she says, I don't want them to mimic me. Rather, she seeks to ferret out the unique shadings and nuances that each of these incredibly skilled dance artists can bring to their roles. One signature of Pickett's work is her ever-flowing and poetic movement quality. She always has bodies doing things they don't ordinarily do, yet the singular, diaphanous movement always comes across as organic and natural. Another Pickett signature is the theatricality that imbues her dances with drama and immediacy. Thus, there is more theater in her dances and also more gesture. For her, a torso is fluid and gorgeously expressive, and hands are the key to the human soul. The importance of hands, of touch, make her choreography both intimate and highly gestural. She will tell her dancers, if you put out your hand and I can make a story from your gesture, I'm sold. She also assures them that plot and drama can be conveyed through small details. She'll tell them, the side of your neck can tell a story. Opening your mouth can tell a story. It's this accumulation of movement and detail that create a world that you, the audience, can understand, believe in, and find profoundly moving. In Crime and Punishment, the dramatic web of relationships that surround Raskolnikov are so intriguing and vivid that the story of Raskolnikov's journey toward redemption has captivated readers for more than 150 years. Now, as a ballet, it is certain to captivate audiences, for the raw and profound humanity that Dostoevsky uncovered is so very relevant to the world we live in now. And as Helen Pickett and James Bonus know, they beg to be explored in dance. Fortunately for them and for us, the dancers of American Ballet Theater have the imagination and brilliance to take that journey with her. And what does it mean to a choreographer to work with dancers of this quality? It means, says Pickett, that the magic needed to tell this story is born. Thank you for being here and joining me for Behind the Ballet.